In Milwaukee, nearly 50,000 local fans root for a repeat of last year's seventh game triumph, but in the second, with Berra on first, Howard lays down a bunt. Torrey fields, but fumbles the flip to Burdett at first, runners on first and third. Jerry Lumpy up next. Grounds one to Torrey, who worries about Berra, throws late to first and hits the runner. Bases loaded. Next batter, Moose Scourin. The Moose grounds one to short. Lumpy is forced, but Berra scores, and the Yankees tie the score. Tony Kubek next at bat, lifting a sacrifice fly to left. Howard comes across to make the score 2-1. Turley takes the mound for the Yanks in the third and holds tight till the sixth. Del Crandall smashes a four-bagger to tie the score. It's one of only two hits off Turley in 6 2/3 innings of brilliant hurling. The score is still tied in the eighth, two out, Berra at bat. Yogi lashes a double off the fence, and the Yankee rally is on the way. Nelson Howard wraps Burdett's third pitch through the center to drive Berra across with a winning run. Andy Carey is next. Hitless in 11 trips to the plate, he reaches Burdett for a scratch single, and the rally is still alive. Two men on as Scourin comes to bat. And the Moose slams one over the left field fence to put the Yankees way out ahead, 6-2. History does not repeat itself for Lou Burdett in the seventh game of the World Series. Last year's hero is this year's loser. But the Yankees know from sad experience the Braves are always dangerous, and there's no rejoicing till the last out, which comes in the ninth after Turley has yielded only two hits. Red Scherndienst lifts a long fly, an easy out, and the World Series is over. For the 18th time in 24 World Series, the New York Yankees are once again the champions.